If you're wondering how to swap an eSIM plan from one iPhone to another iPhone, let's say you upgraded or you got a new phone or something, this video is for you. I'll show you the step-by-step process for transferring your eSIM profile from your old phone to your new phone. First, eSIM stands for Embedded SIM Card. It's actually a SIM card that's embedded in the logic board on your iPhone. This is great because it allows you to use two plans at the same time. You can see I have an AT&T plan here that's actually Los Mobile, and I have my Verizon Play More plan as the secondary line. A lot of people like to use eSIM for combining their work phone number and their personal phone number on one device. That makes it super convenient. Or you can take advantage of things like T-Mobile's free trial, where you can test out the T-Mobile network before you switch. You can also get eSIM plans when you travel abroad via international eSIM add-ons. So that's kind of what eSIM is, but how do you switch an eSIM plan from one iPhone to another iPhone? You can't just pop out the SIM card tray like you can with a physical SIM card and literally just swap the SIM. So how do you do it? Well, it turns out that the eSIM plan is actually tied to your Apple ID or your iCloud account. What you want to make sure is you're signed into the same iCloud account on both iPhones. In this case, I'm signed into the Best Phone Plans iCloud. And then if I go into Cellular on the phone on my left, you can see I have Cellular data as Los Mobile, and I have the Verizon Play More plan as my physical SIM card and Los Mobile as my eSIM plan. Then on my new iPhone, all I'm going to do is jump into Cellular. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to tap Add Cellular Plan. This is where you can normally scan a QR code, but you can also see at the bottom, I have a whole selection of plans to choose from. What you're gonna wanna do is select the plan that you wanna transfer. In my case, it's Los Mobile ending in 1411. So I'm gonna go ahead and find that right here. I'm gonna tap on it and I'm gonna tap Add Cellular Plan. And it says to complete this transfer, approve it on the iPhone currently using this cellular plan. So I'm gonna tap OK. And then I see a pop-up on my old phone that's asking if I wanna complete the transfer. And I'm gonna tap transfer. And this should transfer the eSIM over, again, from your older device to your newer device. And it says activating here. And so we're just gonna wait for that to complete. It may take a couple minutes. I'll let you know exactly how long it takes for me. And boom, there you go. That took about 1 to 2 minutes. It says add cellular plan. So I'm gonna tap continue. It says choose your cellular plan labels. I of course have my Magenta Max plan, and this is the new one that I just transferred. I gave it a custom label, Los Mobile, because that is what the plan is, and that looks good to me, so I'm gonna tap continue. And now you get to choose your default line. You can choose the physical SIM card, in my case, which is Magenta Max, or Los Mobile. I'm gonna go with Los Mobile in this case and tap continue. It says which phone number do you want to use with iMessage and FaceTime. I'm actually gonna pick Magenta Max for this one, so you can kind of switch those up depending on which phone number you want for which application, and tap continue. And cellular data, I'm gonna go with Los Mobile in this case because it does have really good priority on the AT&T network, and I will allow cellular data switching, and I'm gonna tap continue. And then you get to choose which phone number you want to use for your contacts. In my case, I'm gonna go with Los Mobile, and I'm gonna tap continue. And this is asking again, and I'll tap continue, and again, and again, I just have so many eSIM plans at this point. That's why I'm getting so many options here. But there you go. That is how you transfer your eSIM plan from your old iPhone to your new iPhone. And you can tap and select which plan you want to use for cellular data and configure the options of the plans in your phone settings. Of course, if you want to switch your default voice line, you can do that at any time in your settings. And finally, once the switch has taken place, you may just want to make a test phone call or do a cellular data speed test just to confirm things are working properly. So this is on the AT&T 5GE network here in my apartment, and you can see, yep, cellular data is working properly and everything seems to be working great. And the final thing for me is on my previous phone, it says cellular data Los Mobile, of course. Since Los Mobile was transferred off, I'm gonna go ahead and switch that over to Verizon Play More so I can keep using this phone as I normally would. And there you go, that's it for this video. That is how you switch your eSIM plan from your old iPhone to your new iPhone. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and Patreon supporters can now vote on what video they want to see next. Cast your vote by joining the Patreon at the link in the video description. I'm Stetson, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.